Since past few modules, we have been looking into various aspects of access point detection using the aerodump ng command, which not only gives us the name of the access point, but it also gives us various details related to the MAC address, the power, the number of beacon frames that it is sending, the encryption scheme which it uses, etc. Now, aerodump ng is a very nice tool to do the Wi-Fi analysis, but the problem is it is command line. So in a way, if you have 40 to 50 Wi-Fi devices which are available in your area, it becomes a bit difficult to analyze each and every aspect of it. So from the later modules, we'll be using a graphical way of detecting the wireless devices through various tools such as Kismet. So Kismet is basically a very wonderful tool which not only gives us the graphical representation of the output which we typically see in the aerodump ng, but it has a lot of different features. One of the very interesting features is that it automatically decodes the hidden SSIDs. So in the previous modules, we had to run the aerodump ng command logged onto a particular BSSID and wait for the client connection to appear. Kismet, on the other hand, as soon as the client connection will appear, it will automatically replace the hidden SSID with a valid SSID name. Not only this, but Kismet can also work as an intrusion detection system and is used to detect various type of wireless attacks such as sniffing from softwares like NetStumbler, etc. So it gives us a detailed information. Everything is graphical, and that is why Kismet is used lately a lot. One of the features that I like a lot about Kismet is that its ability to integrate with the GPS data. So what happens is, once you roam around your city with your laptop, you can actually map all the access points that you find through GPS. So next time you have a map and you know that the particular wireless access point is present in a particular area. So let's say red indicates WEP. So here you have around 6 web devices. So next time you roam around the city, you know that this particular location has a WEP devices. And this is possible to map with Kismet. One of the places where Kismet is generally used is when a person wants to have a detailed analysis of the available wireless devices in his street or maybe even in his city. So in order to do that, he can use various techniques such as war walking, war driving, even war flying. And let's look at each of them. So war walking is a technique where an attacker puts his laptop maybe on his hand or inside the bag with the wireless adapter and Kismet running. He walks around the area in his street, and Kismet basically will locate all the wireless devices which are available in the vicinity. He can then use the information to create a detailed map of the available Wi-Fi devices and their encryption scheme at a particular location. The problem with war walking is you cannot walk long distances. Maybe you can walk around your building or around your street. So the next thing that you have is called war driving. War driving is where an attacker or the analysis person puts his laptop along with the wireless adapter in his car and he drives around the city. Once he does that, he uses the available information, maybe through Kismet, to map the wireless devices throughout the city. So in this picture, you can see an attacker has mapped a lot of wireless devices in his city with the GPS data, and this is what exactly you can do with a war driving. Along with this, there are various other terminologies like war flying, where attacker has his laptop along with a very powerful antenna inside his plane, and he drives the plane across the cities to locate the GPS Wi-Fi devices available. I guess war flying is a bit too extreme and at a personal level, it is out of my financial capacity to do a war flight. But would be interesting to see if anyone of you can afford war flight. Anyways, along with war flying, I've seen so many funny things like war cycling, where attacker puts on his laptop along with the Wi-Fi adapter and cycles around the city. And this one is very interesting. I really do not know what to say to this type of thing, but seriously, people are finding a very innovative way to locate the Wi-Fi devices in your area. If you have one of the innovative ways to do this, please share a photo along with me. Even I might want to do it someday. So this is all about this module. In next module, we'll be looking into the Kismet in much more greater detail, and we'll see how we can use various features to make our analysis life easier. So I hope this lecture has been informative for you, and I would like to thank you for viewing.